I'm very, very proud to introduce our first speaker, Congresswoman Gabrielle Giffords. She's perhaps the most vocal solar enthusiast we have in Congress today, and I think it has many reasons for that. In part, she's from the 8th District in Arizona, so she's very familiar with the power of the sun. But she's also a very strong leader in technology and in science, and she realizes that solar has literally an unlimited resource and is an absolute critical part of our energy mix going forward. So please help me welcome Congresswoman Giffords.
Ron, thank you for that very kind introduction and for giving us really all the reasons that we're all supporters here, right? I mean, kind of like preaching to the gospel, right? You know, I'm preaching to the choir. We really understand, those of us that are in the tent today. But I think it's important really to hear industry leaders articulate why it is that solar is so important and why now. Solar Decathlon provides us an opportunity to come together every couple of years to look at the best and the brightest in innovation, the students from all over our country and, in fact, other parts of the world as well, coming together to build these incredible homes, these precious pieces of innovation that 20 years from now we're going to look back and laugh and think, oh, that was so silly back then, and now it's something that was so innovative back in 2009, and here we are, you know, moving forward into the future. Now, I mean, I think about how a member like myself, a member of Congress, yes, it's true, I'm from the sunny state of Arizona, but I have a master's in planning from Cornell University, and what drew me to Cornell and that degree was the integration of science, but also of design. And what's so important about these homes that we're seeing is it's not just that they're homes with solar on it. There is a combination of innovation and technology, but also of beauty and design, and that it's a beautiful place to live. In the Congress, we really have our work cut out for us. I'm happy to report, just like this new poll shows, a lot of Americans are supportive of solar, want to put solar on the roofs. There's a lot of members of Congress that are supportive of solar. But at this point, they're not quite at the level of understanding that solar is serious energy. They still think of it as more of a niche, more of a, oh, someday, a futuristic sort of energy, which just simply isn't true. So we have a lot of education to do. Some of that education took place yesterday. Very pleased to get our solar roadmap bill out of the full science committee after a couple of hours of debate and many amendments. Many amendments were excellent from the minority party, from the majority party. We really built a better bill. But the solar roadmap bill is designed to ramp up to 75% of R&D funding coming out of the Department of Energy. Will go through an 11-person commission that's going to be made up of the private sector, going to be made up of academia, and made up of government as well, so that we have a plan just like we had back in the 1980s from the national semiconductor industry. It's very similar where we are today with solar, where we were 25 years ago with national semiconductors, when we were concerned about the Japanese, of course, beating us in this form of technology. The debate was important yesterday as we moved the bill forward in the House and the Senate. You know, I encourage all of you to really engage. When the cap and trade bill started moving on the floor and in committees, what we found, of course, is that those of us who knew and understand solar were very supportive of trying to put additional solar amendments on and to try to promote this type of energy. But unfortunately, the traditional fossil fuels have a lot more money. They have a lot more current jobs, they have a lot more people that are embedded in the industry, and they outmuscled us. But you know what? Progress is on our side and the future is on our side. And that advocacy is so important for folks, you know, employees, for if you're a student out there, if you're an industry advocate, to get on the phone, to march to Washington, and look up your member, and talk specifically about what solar means, what it means from a job standpoint, what it means from a national security standpoint, what it means for an environmental standpoint. You know, this is a win-win-win situation. And I want to look back 20 years from now and know that we stood out in a tent on the National Mall talking about the promise of solar energy. But in the future, we know that we're really going to be able to deliver it. And the United States has led and needs to continue to lead. But we can only do so with your support. So thank you, Sia, for everything you've done, and to NREL, of course, at the Department of Energy for hosting this incredible opportunity, this competition. It's really a delight to be here, and I look forward to advocating with you in the future. Thank you.